Eighth win in conference. How do you feel with a nail-biting finish?
Two parts. Our kids do a really good job of constantly being resilient. And that word keeps coming out of my mouth. Like, our kids find a way to be able to finish a game, find a way to be able to be on the positive side of winning in general. And the other aspect of it from the coaching perspective is how do we then be able to expand upon our lead and build and put a team away so that it doesn't have to come in the fourth quarter, last possession opportunities. And so, like, those are two different aspects of, like, things as a coach and from my perspective that we need to be able to kind of clear up here a little bit as we got six basketball games left here to be able to finish the Big South play.
You guys had a really tough game at Radford, went into overtime, really tough game tonight. What do you think was the difference tonight versus Radford?
Our poise and our ability to be able to finish plays defensively. Like, we did a really good job of then holding them to one and done defensively from the fourth quarter. And so they had a stretch there where they got three or four offensive rebounds to finish the third quarter. But that was the extent of the offensive rebound opportunities for them. And for us to be able to go one and done and be able to push in transition, we're really, really good as we move it and play with pace and space. And so I love our kids' ability to be able to put some confidence and some pressure on the defensive side of the floor so we can get out and run and push in transition.
You talk about composure. Your girls went 15 for 19 tonight for free throws. Ultimately, was able to secure the game at the end of the day. How do you guys work on that composure?
Man, like,
it's hard to simulate that pressure in practice. So
yeah.
What do you attribute to your girls being able to do that?
They've been put in the situation consistently, and as they are put in the same situation to be able to step up and be there at the free throw line with the game on the line or in pressure situations, like, they have built a lot of confidence. And so, like, we say it, I tell them all the time, like, put confidence in your pocket and let that build. Let that stack over and over and over again. And so when you're in pressure situations, you can go back to the success that you've had previously. And so our kids consistently do that. And you know, as we build this program, we're building this program in the right direction. And our kids are going to be able to figure out ways to be able to not just win games, but be competitive and then be able to kind of lean on each other. You know, and as Big South play happens and it's getting in late into February, it's our ability to be able to stay connected as a group. You know, all 13, 14 kids that we have on this roster to be able to work on the we versus me situation and making sure that we are building in the right direction.
You guys got a really important couple games coming up. You got Asheville on Saturday and you have High Point back at the Hodge. You guys have been extremely dominant at home this year. You are undefeated so far in conference within the Hodge. How do you feel with the road game and a big home game coming up?
Really good. Like, our ability to be able to stay focused on the present moment, you know what I'm saying? To be able to not look into the past and be able to see what we've done previously, but to be able to stay in the next 24 hours. So tonight we'll be able to celebrate our successes, and then tomorrow morning we kind of got to be able to flip the page and then be able to worry about Asheville on the road. Asheville on the road is a really, really tough opponent. They shoot it really, really well at home, and so it's going to be a tough basketball game for us to be able to travel down there and be able to come away with a victory.